What is PAS 1192 Part 2? PAS stands for Publicly Available Specification. It enables an emerging standard to be rapidly developed in response to an immediate industry need. In this case, PAS 1192 Part 2 was developed to support BIM adoption in the United Kingdom. It provides a consistent industry-wide framework for collaborative working and information management in a BIM Level 2 environment. PAS 1192 Part 2 evolved from the British standard BS 1192, published in 2007. That document set out the code of practice for the collaborative production of building project information. BS 1192 is effectively Part 1 of the PAS 1192 Part 2 publication. It is still relevant today. PAS 1192 Part 2 focuses on information that is originated, exchanged, or managed in a BIM format. BS 1192 covers all other areas of project information management. So why the need for these documents? Well, producing information that is unnecessary, confusing, not structured properly, poorly coordinated, and or difficult to find has been found to add around 20-25% onto the cost of delivering our built environment. Having greater integrity and taking more care of the way we structure our data can eradicate this waste from the process. Greater clarity will give us improved levels of efficiency, leading to time and cost savings. When we focus our energies on the important parts of the process, rather than on searching for or interpreting information, we become more effective. This can ultimately improve the quality of the built environment that we all live our lives in. The important point here is that this approach requires more discipline, not more work. So what does the PAS 1192 framework look like? Well, it's aligned to the latest RIBA work stages and recognises information increasing through the project delivery period to the point of handing over the new asset to the customer and end user. At this point, with the information at its richest, data is passed to the customer and end user to enable them to operate their new asset. Collectively, this data is known as an information model, though it must be noted that a physical 3D model is only one part. BIM is a process, not just 3D modelling. Data generated in the project delivery phase sits within the project information model. Once handed over and in operation, this is known as the asset information model. The model can be continually enriched during the operational phase to assist in managing the asset. PAS 1192 Part 2 covers the project delivery phase, stages 1 to 6 only. The operational phase of a building's life cycle is covered by a separate PAS document following on from PAS 1192 Part 2, cleverly termed PAS 1192 Part 3. All information must be exchanged in a common data environment accessible by the whole project team. PAS 1192 Part 2 sets out clear protocols for the authoring and sharing of information in a common data environment once it is ready to be published. Key documentation is required throughout the project lifecycle to support the process. This starts at the outset of capital expenditure on an asset with the Employer's Information Requirements, or EIR. Here the strategy for meeting the customer's needs is determined. The EIR sets out the information that a customer will require to run their new facility and to make decisions about its development during the project delivery process. With this strategy in place, procurement can occur and the BIM execution plan, based on the EIR, can be created. The execution plan explains how the information modelling aspects of the project will be carried out and is a key document for all parties. Following the process of contract award, the Master Information Delivery Plan is produced. This sets out the information that is to be prepared, who needs to prepare it, and the protocols and procedures for its production and release. This can only be developed from the BIM Execution Plan and EIR. It is essential that it is in place prior to the start of the design process. From this firm foundation, the project team can mobilise and commence the project delivery process, building their information model in full alignment with the customer's needs and requirements. At the point of handover, operating expenditure commences and the asset management phase begins. This period is governed by PAS 1192 Part 3, as we discussed earlier. By possessing a data-rich information model, the customer and end user are able to assess the performance of their built asset and wider property estate over time. This allows them to be better informed when renewing their assets and commencing the delivery process again in the future. The cycle is supported by continual information exchange between the project team and key customer decision points throughout. PAS 1192 Part 2 is a key document in managing Level 2 BIM projects. visit the British Standards website for more information or to download a copy.